Hello children, welcome back to social class. Last class we were in the lesson that is social and religious reformation movement. In that we already came to a part that is Satya Shodhaka Samaja. I'll start from there only in today's class. Clear? No. Let's go for a Satya Shodhaka Samaja.
Yes, here also, as a person, given that as a priority for a non-profit class, we learn the result.
they can draw the water from his well. He was having a well, and even as a person, other people, they are not giving their permission to draw water from their well. It's only, but as a Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, he given a permission for them. He was allowed them to draw the water for from his well also. Even as a, this personality, he was giving them as a support from his well. Her name is the Savitri Bai Phule, and along with her, both are also they started or established there as a hostel for a girl in order to stay, in order to give a protection, in order to give a education. For that purpose, they started there as a hostel also here. And here we can get the result, or we can get to know about information. It is none other society based equality. The main intention of them means the Mahatma Jyotiba Phule and Savitri Bai Phule, both are also, they are giving the intention for these work. Whatever the work they are doing, why? Because there is a main intention, that is a society based equality here. In a society they should bring, or they wanted to bring there as a equality here. Such a good work. It was inspired by one of the most important prominent personality. He is none other than Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he was influenced by this work, and also he became a follower. Follower, what was he influenced by this the work of this couple also. Here, I hope you understand me, when he was started, and as who was started, what is the main intention here, during which period was stayed, and during that time, what was happened, we learned it, and even as a person about this book, and about the school, why he was started, and who was topic. I hope you are understanding very clear. Is all no? Now let's go for another one. There is the Alighar Reformation Movement. Alighar Reformation Movement. During the last, or about during the last part of the 19th century, or the end part of the 19th century, during the end of 19th century, what happened here is we all have this all a movement. It was all a reformation. It was came during the 19th century, we learned it. As a total, during the end of the 19th century, there will be a new and the religious reformation. It was a set up in the mind of the Muslim community here. New wave. New wave. It was again in the Muslim community. New wave of social and religious reformation. It was came in a Muslim community. And even when it was came on, what it was brought here is that is the after the 1857 movement. After 1857 incident, as a anti-British sentiment, it was again in the mind of anti-British sentiment, means they are opposing the British here. So which one it was came here means anti-British sentiment. It was again in the mind of Muslim community. And even as or what result it was brought here means, even though as a whole these community people, they stay away from that the English education. These communities, they stay away from English education. During that time, they brought that English education. Even as they became as an anti-British sentiment, it was again the mind of the Muslim community, lost that way, they stayed away from the English education. What it was Muslims community. So I hope you are understanding about this one. This one I told you that during the end of 19th century there was brought as a new wave of social and religious reformation movement in the Muslim community, and even they became as a the anti-religious sentiment was again in the mind of the Muslim community. Very was brought here this after the incident of the 1857, and even because of that sake, Muslim community people they stay away from the English education. When they stay away from Muslim education, it was a resulted as a these people they missed the many opportunities. It is mainly based on English education. During that time only, one of the person, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. As this person, he wanted to start a new movement. He was waiting for that to start or to attempt to start that as a new movement, and he got that as an opportunity also. These people, they stay away from that. So, yes, of course, here also, during that time only, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, he wanted to start as a new movement here, and he was starting. Literary Society in the year 1863. During that time, he was starting the Mohammedan Literary Society, and to that he was starting the sentiment and discussion. Whenever debate and discussion it will be held, it was a mainly
it is one of the other.
authoritative book and even about the other books on Islam. In the many other books are there in Islam, that all books will be there by Dr. Devaiwan. Other books are Devaiwan. It was told by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. And even though, along with that, he said that one religion, it has to be interpreted according to the changing time. Whenever, as about the changing time, it was offered that it should be as about one religion, it should be interpreted with the another religion. Or else, the religion it will become as a sluggish. And he fought against with the many other important things. And even as a person, he was fought against the way. Tradition, superstitious belief, and also about the tolerance, and also even about the irrational thought. Irrational thought toward the Almighty. It was a fought, or it was a fought against with the many other things. It is another about the tradition part. Whatever the tradition they are practicing, they are also going to communicate with that mantra, along with that superstitious belief, and about the tolerance, and about the irrational thought also. And even as a person, he told another one most important thing. He said that without the open mind, the social and the intellectual development, it is impossible. Means in order to think that as a development, we require that as a changes here. So we have to open up our mind. It is not open up our mind means opening our mind. No. Means we have to think what is right and what is wrong. What he said here is without an open mind the social and also intellectual development it is of no use or it is impossible. It was told here. And even as about the Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, he was not or he did not support the as about the parda system for a women. Means they are wearing the as a cover of that is a parda we can consider. And even as a person he was not supported for that matter. Another one is he was supported for education for a Muslim girl. Because earlier they are not getting their as education, but here this personality he was given there as important. Means he was supported for a education for a Muslim girl, and also he did not accept that about the polygamy system. We learned that about the meaning of polygamy. It is none other that they are as a person he was marrying or he was marrying then more than two people. Is or no? So marrying her more than two people we can consider it as a polygamy. Monogamy, biogamy, polygamy. We learned that is or no? So I hope you are understanding about the parda, about the education, and about the polygamy. Here, he did not support, didn't support, and here he supported, and here did not accept, didn't accept. So I hope you are understanding. So Syed Ahmad Khan, he did not support the parda system for women, Muslim women, and also he supported for the education it should be given for a Muslim girl, and also he did not accept this polygamy system. So these are the main aspects will be there. It is a part of his struggle we can consider. And in order to bring or in order to implement these part or in order to implement these aspects into our reality, he founded that as one of the important things, that is the Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College. Anglo-Oriental College. In order to bring or in order to bring these all matters in or in order to implement these matters in the reality, for that reason it was founded as a Mohammedan Anglo-Oriented College. Ramakrishna Mission. You are familiar with this name. So, as for this Ramakrishna Mission, it was provided as a unique contribution. What contribution it was brought here is contribution that is a spiritual.
In Calcutta.
and also about the Alhambra, that is in Uttar Kannada. As about the Ramakrishna Mission, we can see in Belur in Kolkata, and its branch we can see in Alhambra, Uttar Kannada also. And what is the main intention of this Ramakrishna Mission? Means in order to preach or in order to spread the message and also thought of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Why it was brought here? Means intention to lead the children. What is the intention? Means in order to spread the thought and also the message of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Who is he as a Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa? Is none other, is one of the spiritual guru of Swami Vivekananda. Guru of Swami Vivekananda. And even as a person, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he was became as he is a worshipper of a goddess Kali, and also even he became as a priest, that is in the Kolkata Kali Mandir. And while preaching to people, he told that as a what can attain a moksha or what can attain a nirvana, how he can be attained here means through dhyana and bhakti. That is the most important thing he told, that is in order to attain moksha. What it is, main important thing it is required here is dhyana and bhakti. Dhyana and bhakti. So I hope you are understanding. Even as a person, he was became as a worshipper of a Kali Mandir, and as he became as a priest for worshipper of a goddess Kali, and also even he became as a priest of a Kolkata Kali Mandir. Whenever he was teaching the people, he told that as a what can attain a moksha, that is through a dhyana, and also that is through a bhakti also. And even along with that, his life will be there. Whenever he was telling that, and it was a great to people, when it will be reached here, means when they are understanding, it is clear, yes or no? So that's what his life will be there itself. His life is itself was a one of the example for this model we can consider. Means he himself was became as a model for his preaching. Whenever he told, like that only he became, and it is considered God as it is a model, yes or no? So that's what they are telling that as a his life is itself, it was a became as a model for a people here. And even as a person, he told another one most important thing, that is all the religion, it was having there as, or it was advocated, almost all they are advocated the same they are telling. Means whatever they are telling, it is mainly depending on their religion, is or no? And even along with it, another most important thing was he told, there is another way also will be there in order to attain a moksha, in order to preach a God also. And this idol worship will be there, it is inevitable as it was told by Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. So I hope you are understanding this Ramakrishna Mission. It was brought or it was bringing as a unique contribution. What contribution it was brought here is, it was bringing there as a development. It was bringing there as a awareness. What type of awareness and development it was brought here is, spiritual growth, cultural development, and also the nationalistic awareness it was brought in the mind of the people. Where we can see or where it was found? It was found in Belur, that is in Kolkata, and as later its branches will be there in many other places, and even in that one that one is in the Alhambra, it is in Uttar Kannada. And the whenever they started about this mission, it was having there as its own aim and intention. What was that here is, that is in order to spread the thought and also about the message of a Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Who is he? Is none other, is the spiritual guru of a Swami Vivekananda. We are familiar about this personality, yes or no? And even as a person, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he became there as a priest. feast and worshiper of our Kali. And also even along with that, we told that also we preach the people regarding attaining a moksha. And also there are other ways also we can to reach a God or to attain a moksha also we told. And how it will be understood by our people means his life is itself, it also became as a example for a modern kingdom as a people. And he told that as a idol worship people that it is inevitable. As a Swami Vivekananda, you know that when about that he preached or about he spread that messages. For that reason, it's a spread of the messages and not of the Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. That is for that purpose only he was studied there as a Ramakrishna mission here. Clear? And in the next class, we are learning about the Swami Vivekananda matter, what he brought and who was inspired here and what it all it was brought by him. And as remaining part we are learning in the coming classes, children. Till then, take care. Thank you.